One of the most annoying things is realizing that some program in Windows decided that it's just going to start up with your computer and you didn't realize it right away, and it's been hogging resources for who knows how long. But it turns out there's a feature in Windows that's not enabled by default, but notifies you just in this type of situation. It'll actually tell you as a notification that there is a new app that is now configured to start when you log in. And also later, I'll go over some cool free tools and stuff to manage other hidden startup apps that I think you'll like. In Windows 11, it's really easy to enable. You just go into the settings menu, then go to System, Notifications, then look for Startup App Notification. And it'll just be among all the other notification settings for other apps. It's not separated, so look for it in there. And then that's it, it should work. And I'll show you how to test it in a quick second. Now for Windows 10, I believe this should still be a feature. Apparently, I was reading articles that it was added in Windows 10 way back in like 2020. However, in my virtual machine, I run Windows 11, I couldn't get it to work in Windows 10, and I don't believe there's a setting for it. I think it's just automatic, so your mileage may vary with Windows 10, but it might work. But in Windows 11, there's an actual setting for it. It should definitely work. Now, there are a few things to understand about how this works. First of all, it's not gonna necessarily detect every single startup app, specifically those that are started via scheduled tasks or as services that run purely in the background. But what you can be sure of is any app that shows up in the list of startup apps in the settings menu. So if you go to settings and then apps and then startup, anything that shows up in here will receive a notification, as well as in the task manager, the startup tab in Task Manager. It's the same thing as this menu. So anything that shows up there newly will get a notification. And this actually can be useful not just for newly installed apps, but sometimes you might just be updating an app and it'll add a new feature or something that gets startup automatically that you might not want to use. For example, here's this hotkey feature thing from Microsoft's Dev Home app. It's a separate startup item that was created and I was notified about, and it just runs in the background, so I wouldn't have known about it. So it's not always if you just install new programs. It could be useful in other cases. If you want to test this out, there's a really easy way. You can go into the startup folder in Windows. This is a folder that you can access by going to the start menu, typing in run, and then in the run box, type in shell startup, and this will take you to a special startup folder. And if you didn't know, any shortcut or program that is in this folder will automatically run with Windows. It's not the only place that a startup program will come from, but it's one of them and it's the easiest one to use yourself. And these do show up in that startup menu list. So all you can do to test it out, drop a program in here, and then after a few seconds, it's not instant, you should see a little notification and now you know that it works. Though in this case, the program only showed up in the task manager for some reason. I'm not sure why. So task manager might be a little bit more reliable, but it did still show the notification. Now that's not the only place necessarily that certain types of startup apps will come from. So I can go over some other places to watch out for too. Before that though, something else that you need to watch out for is malware targeting your small business, which is where today's sponsor comes in, Bitdefender, and their new product, Bitdefender Ultimate Small Business Security. It's an all-in-one security solution specially tailored for small businesses with up to 25 employees who want affordable, comprehensive protection of devices, even if you have limited or no dedicated IT staff or resources. The protection even extends to Windows servers in addition to employee devices, so you can protect both employee and customer data across your whole network. Across these devices, online activities like email, web browsing, and social media are also shielded. But that's not all. It also features business reputation monitoring and protection to monitor things like company accounts, digital assets, and social media presence for signs of exposure or breach attempts that could damage business reputation and credibility. Plus, there's other features like password management and a VPN for secure remote work. Oh, and with so many new scams out there specifically targeting businesses, the dedicated Scam Assistant AI makes it easy for employees to spot and block suspicious emails, scams, and websites, thanks to its training on all sorts of malicious strategies that you or your employees might otherwise never be aware of. And of course, everything is easily managed from an intuitive centralized dashboard that's actually user-friendly, so anyone can configure it, no cybersecurity skills required. So if you want affordable and comprehensive protection for your small business, check out the link in the description to learn more about Bitdefender Ultimate Small Business Security. And with all that being said, let's continue. Now, in the past, I had made a video detailing all the different possible little startup locations apps can hide in, but I believe most of the ones that are really going to be hidden in the registry and stuff are going to be caught by the menu in Windows by default, so you don't have to really worry about those. But the other ones are probably going to be in one of like two places, either as a scheduled task, or it could be a Windows service, which is an app that basically doesn't even have a GUI necessarily, like an interface. It could just be a purely background running app. And those are accessed through like the services menu. And those show up as like either starting manually, automatic, or could be disabled. And there are a few tools that I can quickly go over that makes it a lot easier to find every possible hidden little startup app, so you don't have to kind of manually look through it. The task scheduler is built into Windows. It's pretty straightforward. Usually a app is just gonna be in like the top level folder of the task scheduler tasks, and you can look through it, and if you want, you can disable it from starting up. There might be other folders that it's created. Just be aware that if you disable a task, it's possible that the app will just re-enable it. So you might want to kind of check in there frequently. But if you see that an app is starting up, you can't figure out where it's coming from, that could be it. Another useful tool is known as Autoruns. This is part of Microsoft's Sysinternals suite. So you run this, it basically will show you every possible startup location, even if it's not necessarily an app, but it could be like a driver or a shell extension, that sort of thing, that will show up here. However, there is one type of registry entry that apparently Autoruns does not support yet. It's one that's, for example, used by Teams. It's in this like system app data type path, although those types of entries will actually show up in the startup menu, so it's not really a big deal. You do have to kind of be careful when using Autoruns though, because it will show you everything, even like Windows system critical things. So don't just go in here disabling stuff that you don't know what it is. It could actually like ruin your system. So probably it's best to, in the options, hide Microsoft and Windows entries, and like that's at least a start, but also again, don't keep going in and disabling stuff. Like if you disable a driver wrong, it'll mess it up. But if you consider yourself an advanced user, you might already know about this. It's a good one to know about. Another app that I just found out about recently that seems pretty decent is called Quick Startup. And it's part of software suite Glary Utilities. But what I really like about this one is how it shows services. So the thing about Autoruns is it'll show you all the services, but it doesn't show you whether or not it's set to Autorun in the service. It just shows you if it's been disabled within Autoruns itself, which I don't like to do. Whereas with this, it'll actually show you if it's set to auto start, and you can specifically separate out the Windows services from app services, because if you just go into like services.msc, which is the default Windows thing, it puts them all together, like the critical Windows ones as well as just unnecessary app ones, although you kind of have to decide for yourself what's unnecessary. Some of them might be more than you think. Anyway, this separates it out, makes it a lot easier, so it's one worth looking at. Now, as for those one type of registry entries that Autoruns apparently doesn't yet support, even though you can go into the task manager or settings startup list and disable it through there, if you do want to know exactly where that startup entry is coming from, you could use Nirsoft's RegistryChangesView. And what you can do is you can create a snapshot as the first one, which will like set a baseline. Then you can toggle it off that startup app in the settings and then use the current registry as the second snapshot. And then it'll tell you which things have changed and then just look for the ones that look like that, and that's exactly where it is if you were curious about that. Now, all that being said, a lot of that's pretty advanced. The main topic of the video, that one setting is going to get you 90% there most of the time. Just knowing if an app is starting up the usual way is good enough for me, and that really helps out knowing about it. Thanks again to Bitdefender for sponsoring. Be sure to check out their new Ultimate Small Business Security product to protect your small business. Link in the description. I'll put links to any tools I mention in the description if you want to check it out. And if you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm and subscribe. I try to make videos about twice a week. If you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about the most hated image format ever. I think you might know what I'm talking about. I'll put that link right there and click on. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.